Greetings to everyone. This is the presentation of the project, the design of bell crank pushrod suspension system. A project by Ajay Sharma, Meet Patel and Abhinandan Rausaria, the students of ITM SLS Baroda University, under the guidance of Associate Professor Joyce Vaghmashi. Now talking about the problem statement, the unsprung mass, which includes the mass of components such as spring, shock absorbers and suspension links, is more, which retards the response time of suspension system. The center of gravity of the vehicle plays a vital role in suspension as it describes the handling characteristics during high-speed cornering. Higher the center of gravity from the ground, lower will be the performance of the suspension system. Adjustability system of wheel spring rate and vehicle ride height, which are generally pneumatically controlled, are very costly. The objective of our project is to design a suspension system for a race or a track car, which reduces the unsprung mass by designing lighter components and replacing the mass of coilover, which is spring and damper, with a simple and lightweight pushrod. The coilovers are mounted inboard, which lowers the center of gravity. The lower ride height setting also helps to lower the center of gravity dramatically. To provide mechanical adjustability for the wheel spring rate and vehicle ride height, which is simple and very cost effective compared to pneumatic system. So in order to design a suspension system, first we need to design a suspension geometry which will describe how the suspension will behave. Camber. When we look at the wheel from the front, tilting the wheel outward or inward is known as camber. If the top of the wheel is tilted away from the car, it is known as positive camber. If tilted towards the car, it is known as negative camber. So the point of adding camber in a race car is that, let's say we have a tire over here that is perfectly vertical, that means zero camber. For a car standing stationary, the tire will have a nice rectangular contact patch. But now let's say this tire goes through a corner. The red arrow pointing outward is the cornering forces, trying to pull the tire in one direction. This cornering forces will deform the contact patch. So now, the contact patch, instead of being nice rectangle, it is something like a triangle. Thus, the outer edge of the tire does most of the work, and the inner side does very little work because of the lesser load. So, you are not optimizing the tire to its full potential. So, the point of adding negative camber is to tilt the wheel in one way such that it can counteract the deformation of the contact patch. So, instead of having the contact patch as a triangle during cornering, you will bring back the rectangular contact shape when the car is cornering. But the downside of adding too much negative static camber is that you will have a triangular contact patch instead of a rectangular contact patch when the car is moving in a straight line. Thus, you will lose a little bit of traction during acceleration and braking, but you will gain traction in cornering. Since we are designing this suspension for a track car, cornering traction is more important than straight line traction. Thus, we will take a negative 3.5 degree of camber at the front and negative 2.5 degree of camber at the rear. Now another important geometric angle is the toe angle. The toe angle refers as the angle that the tires are pointing to when you are looking at from the top. If the tires are pointing in straight forward, that means it has 0 degree toe angle. If your tires are pointing inward to the center line of the car, it has positive toe angle. And if the tires are pointing outward, toe out. Toe angles are very important for the stability of the car. Thus, having 2 degree of toe in at the rear helps in high speed stability, and having 1.5 degree of toe out at the front will help in cornering and handling. KPI, kingpin inclination, is the angle made by line passing through upper and lower ball joint when looking from the front with the vertical. Another important parameter related to KPI is the scrub radius. It is the distance between center of the tire contact patch to where the line of the KPI meets the ground. Having too much KPI can also result in negative scrub radius, which has its own benefits. Minimizing the scrub radius or running a car with negative scrub radius will help to avoid torque steer and also improve stability while braking on uneven traction surfaces. Thus, we have accounted a KPI of 15 degrees. Another benefit of KPI is that when the wheel is turned, with KPI it doesn't just turn right or left, but it also changes camber when it moves, which makes the steering wheel feel heavy, but it also tries to align the self-centering force, which helps the steering wheel to return to its mean forward position. Now Caster is also shifting the steering axis from vertical, but this time looking from the side view in the longitudinal direction. When we move top of the steering axis to rear of the car, it is called positive Caster. Moving it the other way, it's negative Caster. And negative Caster is something you will never hear about, because all the car has positive Caster. Without it, it will be very difficult to drive the car. So where steering axis intersects the ground is at the front of the contact patch of the wheel. It is just like a typical shopping cart wheel geometry, where steering axis is in front of the contact patch. So whenever you move your cart, the wheels will follow the direction cart is going in. Similarly, the vehicle wheels will point in the direction the car is moving in. Thus, 10 degree of caster is selected. Now selecting a right amount of caster and KPI will help in right amount of camber gains in turn. Thus, less amount of static camber is required. After bringing all the angles together, this is what the suspension geometry looks like.
All the components of the suspension are designed on based of the final suspension geometry. Here are the components designed in SolidWorks for the final assembly. First, there are unequal lines of A-arms mounted directly to the chassis of the body connected to the knuckle mountings from above and below.
The design of the bell crank is based on the three mirror agendas. The bell crank is designed with three different mounting points where the rider can adjust the suspension settings from short, firm and stiff. Also, there is a chassis where the design is made in SolidWorks considering all the forces and lightweight agenda. The lower arms, which is mounted with the knuckle of the wheel and the frame itself, where there is a base and plate like arrangement provided to mount the push rod from below. The coilover, which expands and contracts, is based on the damper design mounted to the center of chassis from both the sides of the wheels. The pushrod is connected with the damper and provides the load of the movement of the wheel for absorption to the coilover. It rests on the plate arrangement. With respect to the vehicle type, the road height can be adjustable by adjusting the pushrod and the bell crank mountings. The company mountings are under prior consideration, based on which the design and dimensions of the spindle and knuckle are made, and the assembly is ready by the mountings with bolts, nuts and washers as shown in the final assembly.
Coming to the manufacturing process of suspension system, which includes fabrication of all the components, painting and assembling. First, we fabricated the chassis from a square pipe, which provides all the mounting points for the system. Accordingly, fabricated lower and upper arms, which had ball joints at the both ends. And then we manufactured the push rod using round pipes with eye sockets at both ends. As you can see in the picture, we have used damper with variable spring in order to change the suspension stiffness. Three different points are provided on the bell crank, which allows us to change wheel spring rate from soft, firm and stiff. After fabricating all the components, we test fitted everything with nut and bolt. Further, we disassembled the suspension system for painting all the components in a red-black scheme. Here are some of the final pictures of bell crank push rod suspension system.
Thank you.